Motorola just launched the third version of its great value Moto G handset, which at first glance looks suspiciously similar to last year's model. So what's actually the difference, and is it worth an upgrade? Despite appearances, the new Moto G boasts a couple of decent design improvements over last year's model. Firstly, Motorola now lets you fully customize your Moto G's design with the online Moto Maker tool. Last year's model had swappable covers to change up the look of your phone, but now you can change the color of the front as well as the camera bar, and even get the Moto G engraved with some kind of slushy message. And if you're a bit of a butterfingers, then good news, as the new Moto G is fully water resistant. That means it'll happily survive a dip in the bath or your toilet, even if you leave it in there for half an hour or so for some weird reason. Movie fans may be disappointed to hear that the very same 5-inch 720p panel as last year has been packed into the new Moto G. So, if you're hoping for super sharp 1080p visuals like the Vodafone Smart Ultra 6, you're going to be sadly disappointed. Still, at least the screen is as colourful as ever and still a decent way to take in a movie when you're on the go. And if you want to stream media over the interwebs, you'll be glad to hear that the new Moto G packs 4G support, unlike last year's model. The 2015 Moto G upgrades last year's Snapdragon 400 processor to a Snapdragon 410. And while the 410 is already getting on a little bit, we're still very happy with the new phone's silky smooth performance. Of course, our 2014 model is still running perfectly well, and the new Moto G has similar day-long battery life, so there's little reason to upgrade here. Don't discount the new Moto G just yet though, as the biggest update is easily the new 13 megapixel camera. Impressively, it's the same camera tech found in the premium priced Nexus 6, also crafted by Motorola, and it's a definite boost over last year's 8 meg snapper. With auto HDR, a snappy autofocus, and a dual LED flash, the new Moto G takes sharp, attractive shots in pretty much any conditions. And thankfully, Motorola has kept the same simple camera interface, so it's once again tap to snap, with manual controllers available if you really need them. Not a huge amount has changed for the third generation Moto G, and while the design tweaks are nice, the only real reason to upgrade is that improved camera. However, bear in mind that the Moto G now has hot competition from the likes of Vodafone Smart Ultra 6, which packs 1080p visuals for a little bit less money. For the full third gen Moto G review, check out recombu.com/mobile.